Tom Duscott mod.
It's Tom Dumont. I'm the gamer. Tony's also quite a gamer, actually.
I like playing games too, yeah. Probably not as much as you.
I think, for me growing up, you know, I first got an Atari 2600 system when I was a kid. I think that's like the classic home video game console. You know, all the great games were on that. Can't remember them.
Pong.
Pong. Like, what was the game with the tanks?
Combat,
you know, all that stuff.
That came with the system for free.
Yeah, that was the free one. But, you know, all the others came out. And then, you know, just went on to, like, when arcades came out and were popular when I was a child, like, it was, you know, spent a lot of time at the arcade. I think we all did.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. When I grew up, I used to play Intellivision. And there was, you know, there was the people who played Atari 2600, the kind of run-of-the-mill people who just enjoyed those kind of games. And then there was the Intellivision group of people, intelligent television. You know, it was just a different ilk of people. And, I would play the Intellivision games, and I enjoyed a lot of that stuff. And then I remember when arcades came around, there was one down the street, and my parents would give me maybe a quarter. Well, all the other kids had much more than that, you know, like a few dollars worth of change, but I used to have a quarter, so you'd go down there and then you'd have to pick which game you're going to play, and I was terrible back then because I didn't have much practice, so, you know, the quarter would last a minute and then you'd walk home and that would be pretty much the end of the adventure.
I'm still a kid like these guys, to the point where I have some video games in my house. Miss Pac-Man, Kiss Pinball, Asteroids, Galaga, and Mario Brothers.
The full stand-up
one. The full arcade-size ones.
Tell them about your KISS one.
The KISS one's signed by all four original KISS members.
We found out about the game because the Sierra people came to us, and they proposed that we put some of our songs in this game. And then it kind of evolved into, like, well, maybe you guys can kind of be in the game and do the voice, and that seemed kind of exciting. The thing is that these days, there's so many different kinds of, like, activities kids can be doing, and music seems to be going farther and farther down in people's priorities in their life. So I think it's a really interesting way to kind of introduce new music to people that maybe hearing and discovering bands for the first time, you know, maybe the young 12-year-old boy hears No Doubt for the first time. It's pretty exciting for us and for him.
Well, we're very excited because three songs from our Rocksteady record are going to be in the Malice game: Platinum Blonde Life, In My Head, and Detective. And those, it's kind of cool for us because those aren't necessarily singles off the record, or they haven't been so far. So it's kind of like people get to see a different, maybe a different side of No Doubt, would you say?
I think a lot of times people just hear the songs that are on the radio and they have kind of a preconceived idea of what we are, but if you really get into our albums, it's like there's a lot more than just the singles, and I think it's really cool for people to be able to, like, hear some of those songs in this game, especially if it's the first time they ever are getting into a band or something like that, they can discover us there.
If you study, if you look at movies really carefully, or video games these days, the soundtrack often really, like, helps to underscore, like, the storyline or the emotional side of what's happening, you know, especially in films. But that's, video games have gotten to that point where there's, you know, there's a certain excitement that comes from the music, and I think that those three songs are excellent choices to, you know, to reflect that for Malice.
It's another way to collaborate, you know, with a whole nother medium. And this whole album was all about collaboration in the first place. Rocksteady was like us working with a lot of different people and trying to expand and grow. And like Tom was saying, it's just a whole nother creative way to be involved in a whole nother art. So it's cool for us.
Well, I can tell you that I think both of you are this small. Like, when I look at you, you're this small, and so
really?
Is she, yeah. And you both live on my TV.
Yeah.
And you're both cartoon characters. So those are some things you have in common.
I think Malice and Glenn are both kind of, like, kind of badass in a way. You know what I mean? There's an assertive kind of empowered nature to what, you know, the way they approach what they're doing. You know, you rocking the stage, Malice rocking the game.
Yeah, I kind of see it as like I was saying about the whole, you know, the music world being a little bit of a man's world, and especially like the rock part of it when you get up on stage. And we did that festival the other day, and it was like, it felt so good to be me up there, in the sense that there was like all these rock bands that played before us, and it was very male. And then we got up there and people were still kind of going off, like it didn't matter. I think kind of, if I could like compare the two, mm-hmm. she's like in there and she's fighting all these things. And not to get too serious about it, but you asked if there's any similarities. Does that make sense?
You both fight. You both fight evil, and you both fight crime. Yeah, and you both.